kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. Ingram takes it to 12. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's tackled at the 40.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. And down he goes at the 38.
I think anytime you lose yardage, it's frustrating as a ball carrier. It's very frustrating as a play caller. Makes you a little bit more hesitant maybe to go back to a certain play. The biggest thing you want to do as an offensive coordinator is get the offense over the sideline after the series. Make sure everybody's on the same page, and then show the confidence that you still have in them despite this play, that you're going to go right back to the running back and trust that offensive line.
And that brings up fourth down.
Great stop by the defense. They played with tremendous character on those downs.
Meade is waiting for the snap. And this one is a beauty. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Setting up play action. There's a strike complete.
Well, when you can rely on your tight end to move the chains, you've got a big time advantage over any defense.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. The running back picks up a yard on the counter.
That's good for a gain of 1 yard. That brings up second and 9.
The 41.
Pretty nice pickup here. These guys are getting very tight on their timing.
From their own 41-yard line, it's third down.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
Gets it out quickly. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
This is a quarterback who trusts his receivers, and he knows they can make plays. It's like those two were playing catch out there.
They'll spread the field with five wide. They'll bring him down at the 39.
Well, we've got a new quarterback in there. You have to wonder not only how will he do, but what does this do to the starter's psyche?
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker.
Well, Kirk, we saw this kid head to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury, and now we see he's back on the sideline. That's good news. Looks like he should be able to get back in the action.
Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
First down.
Gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
From the 34-yard line, second down. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
And he's taken down around the 26-yard line.
Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice gain.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive.
I think the play call was the right one by the offense. I just think the defense made a better play. They seem to want it more here on this big third down. Offense comes up a little bit short to set up a fourth down, to give all the credit to the personnel on the defensive side of the ball.
After a decent pickup from the 21-yard line, it's first down. And he's tackled at about the 21.
That makes it 7-10.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. Left going the other way.
He telegraphed that throw. He eyed his receiver the whole way. That was an easy read by the defense.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. Pops free, scoops it up. He makes it to the 42-yard line.
The running back won't be happy that he lost the ball. He's got to forget about it and get ready for the next series. His offense is going to need him again.
So the question on this one is whether or not the ball carrier's knee hit the ground before the fumble popped loose. The coach wants to challenge this one, so we'll take another look at the possible fumble. So after some discussion, the call on the field is reversed. From their own 44-yard line, second down. And he can't get away from the pressure. He's hit and taken down. From the 42-yard line, first down. Run up the middle. We played one. No score here.
That brings him second and 5.
And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter. And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
And he throws it away. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Trying to take the lead by a field goal.
It's up. And he nails the long field goal. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's out to the 30.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Boy, the senior linebacker's experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
From their own 41-yard line, it's second down. Complete. Tackle made around the 44-yard line. Pushed out of bounds at the 44.
Let's see if this coaching staff sticks with the short passing game or if they decide to open it up a bit more.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. And he tackles him hard at the 48-yard line. Stop the 37-yard line. Wow, a long game, but still not enough for the first.
Well, the offense hurt themselves by digging themselves into a hole on first and second down, so the defense didn't really have to put too much thought in how to defend on that third down.
Kicks away, and it's good.
Great snap and a perfect hold, and he just had an awesome follow-through. Everything went right there on that long field goal.
3-3 tie. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Gets out to about the 31.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now.
Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 28. Dumps it right to his fullback. At the 30, to the 20. Knocked out of bounds at about the 15-yard line. A good look and pass that time.
Well, here they do a nice job of getting the ball out to their speedy receiver. And he shows you that he not only can turn on the jets, but he's got pretty decent hands as well.
And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Just throws this one away. Fires complete over the middle.
Any offense is predicated on being able to move efficiently like this.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down.
And they've got all their DBs in there to match up against the five-wide set. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
And he adds the extra point. A six-play, 69-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 10-3. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half.
That makes it second and ten.
And they got him.
He has one job on passing situations. Get to the quarterback. And he did that job very, very well on that play.
Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. They'll work the right side. Nice run, and he's brought down.
I actually liked the call, but it was really smart, disciplined play by the defense.
Kirk, good news. The guy that we saw go to the locker room with that injury earlier is back on the sideline, and I got to bet he's going to be back in the game soon. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset, and they're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
They punched it in for six on the last series. Can they do it again?
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Mike Ford, I got you pumped.
He gets rid of this one. Come out in a five-wide set. And he's hit immediately. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Makes the catch, and look out. Steps out of bounds around the 45-yard line.
That'll make it second to seven.
From the 45-yard line. It's second down. He's out of bounds at about the 39-yard line. Carries the ball for a nice game.
This kind of execution from an offense can really affect the defense and their psyche. That's the second time on this drive alone they've been able to convert on a third down. This defense has got to be able to kind of gather themselves and try to find some confidence. And somebody on that defense has got to be able to make a play to slow this offense down.
Brought down at about the 7-yard line. This is the ninth play in the current drive. Now he's scrambling. Tackle right around the 6-yard line.
Gets to a receiver. Touchdown. So he found his receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 10-play, 62-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
And they can forget about returning this one. The offense will be hoping for a little more success than they had the last time out. And hit hard as he came down with it. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
From their own 28-yard line, second down. In trouble. Zips it to the back. We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 17-3.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 halftime show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. This lead at halftime is not insurmountable. You know, you watched the first half, and I really felt as if this team played hard. They played with a lot of energy and a lot of emotion. Just to be honest about it, David, the coaching staff seemed to be a half step behind. The other guy was ahead of them. They knew their tendencies. Second half, you expect to see them break some of those tendencies?
Sometimes you have to. I mean, sometimes you come out and obviously you put your game on tape. Coaches know what you're going to come out and what to expect from you. And sometimes quarterbacks, they don't like to push the ball down the field. They like to take the easy stuff. You got to take it away. Take away what they do best. And you could tell the first half, they weren't ready for what came their way. Now it's your job at the half to come in, put a plan together, be more aggressive. You're down 2 scores now. You can't afford to be cautious. Put something together to come out to have success in the second half.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set for the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I tell you what, you got to give these guys credit. They put up a great defensive effort in the first half. They carry it over in the second half. Doesn't look like they're going to give in.
Yeah, and this game isn't over yet. I think it's going to require them to continue to play with this kind of edge and attitude to be able to give themselves a chance to win the game because we still have a ball game in our hands and still a whole quarter to go.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a D4 on one double. That makes it 2nd and 6.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. He's tackled around the 36-yard line. He's at midfield. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 44-yard line.
He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 44. Run there.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings him second and five.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Mike four, Mike four.
He steps out at about the 37-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. They go to the ground, and he stops short. The kick is away. It's long enough, and it's off the upright. No good. Here comes the offense as they look to find the end zone yet again. They'll bring him down at the 37. Second down and 11. Ball on the 37. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled at about the 49. Tries to get around the corner. And down he goes at the 48. From the 48-yard line, second down. Slings it.
The receiver was pretty much blanketed, but when you have as accurate an arm as this young man, you can get away with riskier passes sometimes. The kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
First and 10, ball on the 24. Inside the 10, and it pays off. Touchdown. Decided to go to the running back on that touchdown pass.
Just a nice job by the quarterback of showing great patience here, going through his progressions, finally finding the back to get into the end zone.
And he hits the PAT. It was a 6-play, 61-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown. So the score now, 24-3. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Well, here's a team that's just falling apart here in the third quarter. Kind of an embarrassment right now.
In this game, the way it's heading right now, not only does it affect this performance, but I think it affects your confidence. The next game that you're going to play, and the doubt that might creep into the back of your mind.
The sub package in there defensively in this 5 wide receiver set. Short pass, middle of the field. Tackle made at the 28.
That'll make it second and 7.
Go,
from their own 28-yard line. It's second down. He's taken down at the 41-yard line. Feeds it to the back. And they make the stop right around the 42-yard line.
That brings up second and nine.
Second down and nine to go. Ball on their own 42. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go.
That'll bring up third and six.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense.
And he just gets rid of it. And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
Ingram. Deep to return. And this one is a beauty. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Pushed out of bounds
at about the 33-yard line.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important is having receivers that can make plays.
From their own 33-yard line, first down. And he is drilled at the 41.
Second and two.
We head to the fourth. 24-3.
We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter.
Makes it out to about the 50. First and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. He's at the 40. He's hit before he can go anywhere. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. That's a great tackle. The 37-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide. Catches it, and that's all. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. It has the distance, and it's good. has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off.
He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They've really played lights out defense this whole game, and they still got to just hang on here at the end.
Yeah, we're here in the fourth quarter. You're right. They played as well as you can imagine defensively, but they can't let up because we still have some time left in this ballgame.
Their last drive broke down, and they punted. What do they have in store this time out? Out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line.
That's some pretty timid play calling right there. Let's see if they decide to open it up a bit more.
From their own 28-yard line, it's second down. Steps out of bounds, right around the 30. He's got it with room to run. Brought down around the 39-yard line. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver. It's second and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Just under three to go in regulation. He gets rid of this one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
To go long and does. And he hauls it in at the end of that long ball. Tackle at the 13. So let's see how the defense responds now. It's first down and 10. But they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. This is the eighth play of this drive. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. They've been two for two on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. Darts it to the left. End zone, touchdown. And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
And they're looking to get 2 points here. They come out on an empty backfield. They don't get it. A 9-play, 75-yard drive. But the failed two-point conversion keeps it a six-point score.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
And he's taken down at the 38.
You know, I've been so caught up in these offensive players, the quarterback and the receivers, and what's happening on the field. I got to step back for a second and remind all of us what the job the offensive coordinator has done, preparing his team and calling the right plays to give them such a chance to play well.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And they get nice yardage on that run.
gets it out to maybe the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, second down. This one's in the books, and our final score, 27-9. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.